So choosing relationships for the theme of the music, everything, like, we, you know, relationships, is, we deal with relationships all the time. Some are more complex than others, and music usually ties back to relationships. So it's a pretty natural thing to write a song about.
We were investigating the future of relationships through a foresight study that Macy and I were working on together. It was sort of something that Macy had conceived of a little bit, and noticing sort of what might be changing in the world right now, whether that be technological change or changing in people's value systems that might influence the future of how people interrelate and how romantic relationships are designed and constructed. And it seemed that a song would be like the perfect sort of medium to explore this, because there is such a great history of love songs, and it would be like a nice way to sort of understand if there is a future world where something is different about how people relate. What can a song tell us about what that experience is like?
I think it's just how people relate to each other, and I think in our research we were looking at if people turn to more multi-person, complex relationship arrangements, what kind of ways could they look at these arrangements? How might it be designed? And then how might it affect the interrelationships between these people? How might they communicate with each other so that everyone's needs and wants are met? And I think it's also just as like human interactions, or, you know, people talk about relationships as constellations, as like different parts of an atom. So we also took that language into talking about structures of relationships.
When it comes to love and love songs and kind of thing, there is a bit of a contradiction there as well, where there's the, you know, to construct something or to hold something or to formalize something almost is in nature the opposite of what love could be. So we kind of broke down and discussed all of that kind of thing, and to contain love into one thing, or to contain, you know, what the actions of love are, like that kind of thing, but a way of kind of freeing it, but also to have almost like a structure and like a kind of mutually respected and in a secure kind of structure to go by.
Yeah, this song sort of, I guess the leap we're taking into this future is that, you know, in the present we have a small number of sort of well-defined, formalized relationship structures, and so we're imagining a world where there's much greater diversity of types of relationships, similar to the sort of the language we have within the more recent years around different types of identities. What about identifying different types of relationships and even creating frameworks to allow people, to enable people to define completely new sorts of relationships?
And also just to touch on like the ongoing, evolving, living nature of relationships. How could those structures change and mold as people grow, or as people develop, or as the bonds between people change?